functions. Functions is the most elementary and most important chapter of calculus. Calculus contains so many chapters, starting from function, then limit, continuity, differentiability, application of derivatives, indefinite integration, area under curve, and differential equation. But all the other chapters, if you suppose didn't understand functions very well, all the remaining chapters will be very difficult for you. Most important, most elementary chapter in calculus, function. So if the name came function, you must understand what is a function, definition of function. Suppose A and B are two non-empty sets. What are A and B? Two non-empty sets. Suppose in the set A, elements are some A, B, C, D like this. And in the set B, suppose the elements are some 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like this. So these are two non-empty sets. Now, a relation from A to B, a relation from A to B, suppose F is a relation from A to B such that A is related to some 3, C is related to suppose 5, D is related to 1, B is related to 4, suppose some relation is given. Like that, this is a particular relation given. I will say that a relation is a function, definition is a relation F from A to B. We will write like this, but we will read as F from A to B is said to be a function if for all A belongs to A, there exists unique B belongs to B such that F of A equal to B. This is the definition of function. A relation F from A to B is said to be a function if for all A belongs to A, there exists unique B belongs to B such that F of A equal to B. If these conditions of relation will satisfy, we will say that it is a function. For example, see here only A, B, C, D. There are four elements in A. Does every element have some image? Yes, A has the image 3, B has the image 4, C has the image 5, D has the image 3. So first condition that every element must have image, that property satisfied. And second thing is what? Uniqueness. Means every element must have only one image. Now you only see that A, how many images does A have? Only 3. Satisfying. How many images does B have? 4. Only one image. How many images does C have? One image. How many images does D have? Only one image. So in this way, we will say that it is a function. Every element have an image and image is unique. So now the question arises, is there a relation which does not have a function? Yes. So see that. Suppose I will say that this is the set A, B, C. Here is the set 1, 2, 3, 4. If I will define a relation like this, A to 3, B to 4, I will say that it is not a function. Reason, the element C don't have any image. For the function, the two important things. First thing, every element must have image. So here A and B have the image, but C don't have any image. So here only I will say that this relation is not a function. Suppose another example I will take, suppose this is A, B, C. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, relation F I will define as A, B to 2, B to 4, C to 3. Now I will ask you, is it a function? You should say no. Why? A has the image, okay. B has the image, okay. C has the image, means every element have the image. How many images are there for A? 1. How many images are there for C? 1. But for B, how many images are there? 2 images are there. So is it a function? No. Every element must have the image and image should be unique. But here our B's image is not unique. B have 2 images, 2 and 4. So in that way it is not a function. So did you understand? In this whole definition, the two things are very important to consider. every element of the A should have the image, and image should be unique. If any one condition will fail, you will say that it is not a function. Now observe that f from A to B, as I am taking, suppose here this is A, some A, B, C, D, and here is suppose some B, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 suppose, and I am relating like A to 4, B to 1, C to 6, D to 1, like that I am relating. So check it, is it a function? Every element have a image. How many images does A have? 1, B have 1, C have 1, D have 1. So all the properties are satisfying, na? Yes, so it is a function. Now this set A is there, na? This is called domain. What is it called? Domain. The set B is there or not? This is called codomain. What is it called? Codomain. And f of A equal to set of all B belongs to B, such that f of A equal to B for all A belongs to A. This set is called range of F. What is it called? Range of F. For example, in this problem only, if we will discuss, what is the domain? If I will ask for this problem, what is the domain? Set A. Set A is A, B, C, D. If I will ask you what is codomain, you should say set B. What is set B? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But if I will ask you what is range? Range means only images you will take. What is the image of A? 4. What is the image of B? 1. What is the image of C? 6. And what is the image of D? 1. So again, repeated elements we will not write. 4, 1, 6. This I will say is the range of F. Did you understand the three very important terms which we will use later? These things we have to find out. So first thing is what? Domain. If f from A to B is a function, then the set A is called domain, set B is called codomain, and all the images, image set, is called the range of F. What is it called? Range of F. Number of functions. Now if you had studied permutation and combination, you can easily understand this what I am telling. If suppose permutation and combination you had not studied, then try to remember the final formula which I will give. That formula remember. If you had studied permutation combination, you can easily understand what I am doing. So suppose there is a set A having elements A1, A2, A3 and so on, AN, and there is another set B having elements B1, B2, B3 and so on, BM. The question is, how many functions can be defined from this set to this set? So here I will apply PNC. So first element can take the image in how many ways? Means A1 can take either this image or this image or this image or any of this image. Means first element can take the image in how many ways? M ways. Similarly, second element can take any of these following. Second element can take the image in how many ways? M ways. Third element can take the image in M ways, isn't it? Repeated images can be there. If A has the image 1, B image can also be 1, C image can also be 1. So in the same way, last element can take the image in how many ways? M ways. Now we will apply the multiplication principle. Principle of counting, two principles are there for counting, multiplication and addition, which you will study in permutation and combination. Here we will apply the multiplication principle. Means m, how many times? N times. That is m power and these many functions can be defined, that is number of elements in codomain, number of elements in codomain power number of elements in domain. Total number of functions from a set A to another set B is number of elements in B power number of elements in A. These many functions we can define. What is the answer? Number of functions from a set containing n elements to another set containing m elements, m power n. So this is the number of functions. So if I will say that here is the set A 1, 2, 3, 4 and another set is B having elements A, B, C, how many functions you can define from A to B? It will be 3 power 4 from A to B. If I will ask from B to A, it will be 4 power 3, number of elements in codomain power number of elements in domain, means 3 power 4, 81 function from here to here, and from here to here 64 functions you can define. Graphical representation. Graphical representation of function means, suppose any graph is given, suppose any graph is given, how you will check? Every graph need not be a function. Every graph need not be a function. So if any graph is given, how to check whether that given graph is a function? For example, I will draw the graph of y equal to x square, and I will draw the graph of, this is the graph of y equal to x square, and this I am drawing the graph of y square equal to x, and this I am drawing the graph of circle, this I am drawing the graph of a straight line y equal to mx plus c. See that four graphs so far I gave. Now if I will ask you that which of the following graph is a function, how you will check? I know that, so I will say that okay, this is a function, this is a function, this is not a function, this is not a function. But you must ask, what is the logic behind that? The logic is, any line parallel to y-axis if you will draw, suppose this is the point A whose image is this also and whose image is this also, means I want to say that A is an element which have two images. See that this is one image, this is another image. But you only tell me that if an element have two images, is it a function? No. Why? For the function, image should be unique. But here the image is not unique. Here, if you will draw any line parallel to x-axis, it will cut at only one point, means one point have only one image. One point have only one image. So unique image is there, no? So that is a function. But here an element have two images, so that's why it is not a function. Come here also, an element have two images, so is it a function? No. But come here, if you will draw any line parallel to y-axis, it will cut at only one point, so this is again a function. So how you will check graphically whether the given graph is a function or not? So what you will say, that graph of y equal to f of x is function if, graph of y equal to f of x is function if any line parallel to y axis cuts the graph only at one point. y equal to, graph of y equal to f of x is function if any line parallel to y axis cuts the graph only at one point, or no line parallel to x axis, no line parallel to x axis cuts the graph at more than one point. Did you understand? If the line parallel to y axis cut the graph at more than one point, means the image will not be unique and hence that will not be a function. Hence that will not be a function. Now we'll do some problem. Write down. Just the basic problems of function. Suppose if problem is if f of x equal to 1 plus x by 1 minus x, show that f of x into f of x square by 1 plus f of x whole square is equal to 1 by 2. This you have to prove. What do you have to prove? That f of x into f of x whole square plus by 1 plus f of x whole square. This we will calculate. So come on, tell me, what is LHS? F of x into f of x square by 1 plus f of x whole square. So what it will become is equal to f of x 1 plus x by 1 minus x into f of x square, means 1 plus x square by 1 minus x square. Did you understand how? Wherever x is there, that x is replaced by x square by 1 plus f of x 1 plus x by 1 minus x its whole square. So come on, tell me, what you'll get? 1 plus x into 1 plus x square by 1 minus x into 1 minus x into 1 plus x. How? A square minus b square, a minus b into a plus b, by here 1 minus x whole square LCM. So 1 minus x whole square plus 1 plus x whole square by 1 minus x whole square. So see that 1 minus x, 1 minus x, 1 minus x whole square, 1 minus x whole square will get cancelled. So what you'll get? This is equal to 1 plus x into 1 plus x square by 1 plus x square plus 1 minus x square, 1 plus x square minus 2x plus 1 plus x square plus 2x. So 2x, 2x will get cancelled. That is 1 plus x into 1 plus x square by twice of 1 plus x square. 1 plus x square, 1 plus x square cancel, 1 plus x by 2. One plus x into one minus x whole square. Achha, something I didn't wrote, I think. One particular thing I didn't wrote. What is that? See that this 1 plus x and 1 plus x also will get cancelled. So what left? 1 plus x square by 1 plus x square minus 2x plus 1 plus x square plus 2x. 2x, 2x cancel, 1 plus x square by twice of 1 plus x square, and now these two will get cancelled and you will get 1 by 2, which is the answer. Write down. Next problem. One more problem. If y is equal to f of x is equal to 1 minus x by 1 plus x, given that y equal to f of x equal to 1 minus x by 1 plus x, prove that x equal to f of y. We have to prove that x equal to f of y. So come on, tell me, what is f of x given? 1 minus x by 1 plus x. So can you tell me what is f of y? F of y is, this implies f of y is what? 1 minus y by 1 plus y. So this implies f of y is equal to 1 minus, can you tell me what is y? We can keep this one also in place of y. 1 minus y is what? 1 minus x by 1 plus x by 1 plus y is what? 1 minus x by 1 plus x. So what you'll get in the numerator? 1 plus x minus 1 plus x by 1 plus x by 1 plus x plus 1 minus x by 1 plus x. Did you understand? I'm just taking the LCM. So 1 plus x cancel, x and x cancel, 1 and 1 cancel. You will get 2x by 2, 2, 2 cancel. So what you'll get? X left hand side. What is running in the left hand side? F of y. This only you have to prove, that x equal to f of y. Write down. Understand? Next one. Now, algebra of function. Algebra of function. Algebra of function. Suppose f is a function defined from d1 to r and g is a function defined from d2 to r. Did you understand? Particularly I am using d1 and d2, means I want to say they are the domains. D1 is domain of f and d2 is domain of g. Suppose these are the two functions, then f plus g is a function from d to r given as, defined as f plus g of x is equal to f of x plus g of x. F of x plus g of x, and f minus g of x is defined as f of x minus g of x. First one, sum of two functions, difference of two functions. Third one, f into g is defined from d to r as f g of x is equal to f of x into g of x product, and f by g from d to r is defined as f by g of x is equal to f of x by g of x. Here also f plus or minus g I am writing, d to r it is defined as, where your d will be d1 intersection d2, means both the functions should be defined, then only your final d will be defined. This we will discuss more when we will talk about domain. For now, algebra of function means f plus g of x is f of x plus g of x, f minus g of x is f of x minus g of x, f g of x is f of x into g of x, f by g of x is f of x by g of x. Sum, difference, product and quotient of two functions. Write down. Next will come your domain of function. Domain of function. Domain of function. Write down in that. Domain of function. The domain of y equal to f of x, the domain of y equal to f of x is set of all, the domain of y equal to f of x is set of all real values of x, set of all real values of x for which f of x is defined, for which f of x is defined real. See that we generally study, means in functions particularly we will study only the real valued function. Real valued function means a function which is defined from set of all real numbers to set of all real numbers, or subset of real numbers to the subset of real numbers. Means in the domain or codomain, some imaginary or undefined term should not be there. Domain should contains only the real values, and codomain should also contains only the real values. Some real value set to real value set only will define. So did you understand? Y equal to f of x is set of all real values of x for which f of x is defined real. F of x is defined real. So can you tell me when f of x can be non-real? Suppose I will say that an expression in eventh root, suppose x is there in the root over, if I will say x is minus 4, is it real? Can you find the root over of negative number? No. Can we find? No. Means first thing what I want to say, that expression under even root should be, eventh root should be positive, or should be non-negative, isn't it? It can be zero. Should be non-negative, means if I will say that what is the domain of f of x equal to root over of x minus 1, you should say that x minus 1 should be greater than or equal to 0, otherwise is not defined. Means x should be greater than or equal to 1, means x belongs to 1 comma infinity. This will be the domain. Means if you will take any value from 1 to infinity, this root over will be defined positive. But if you will take any value less than 1, suppose 0 you will take, root over of minus 1, root over of minus 1 is iota. Imaginary. Is it a real number? No. So that is the first thing you should consider, that whenever in the eventh root means square root or fourth root or sixth root, in any such cases, whatever the expression will be there inside, that should be non-negative. If that will be negative, the total expression will become imaginary. Second thing to consider is denominator not equal to 0. What happened if denominator is 0? Anything by 0 is not defined. That is another important thing to consider, that denominator should not be equal to 0. Anything by 0 is infinity or not defined, and infinity or not defined is not a real number. We want domain should be real, and range or codomain should also be real. But here if the denominator is 0, anything by 0 will be not defined. Means if I will ask you what is the domain of f of x equal to 1 by x square minus 4, so I want to say that x square minus 4 should not be equal to 0. Come on, tell me when it is 0. Means x minus 2 into x plus 2 should not be equal to 0. Means x should not take 2 comma minus 2. Means x can take any real number except minus 2 and 2, because at these two points denominator is 0, hence the function is not defined. Did you understand? So to find the domains, two important things you have to consider so far. First one, expression under event root should be positive, non-negative. And second thing, denominator should not be equal to 0. Next point. If domain of y equal to f of x is d1 and domain of y equal to g of x is d2, then domain of first one, f of x plus g of x is d1 intersection d2, isn't it? A function will be defined. This function will be defined if both the functions will be defined. Both the function will be defined means for this domain, common thing. Common thing means their intersection. Similarly for minus also, f of x plus g of x or f of x minus g of x, your domain will be d1 intersection d2. What about f of x into g of x? Then domain of f of x into g of x is also d1 intersection d2. But if I will ask you domain of f of x by g of x, first of all both the functions should be defined, that is d1 intersection d2, but minus set of all x such that g of x is 0. Because see that in the d2 when you will talk about domain, gx can be 0. But if g of x is in the denominator, can it be 0? No. So f of x by g of x domain will be d1 intersection d2 minus all those values where g of x is 0. Is it clear to you? Write down. So just very basic problems we will do based on this domain. Write down. Find the domain of f of x equal to, okay, problem is find the domain of f of x equal to root over of x square minus 5x plus 6. X square minus 5x plus 6. So come on, tell me. As I told, root over is defined when the expression should be non-negative. Means x square minus 5x plus 6 should be greater than or equal to 0. Now, this is what? X minus 2 into x minus 3 should be greater than or equal to 0. What are the roots? 2 and 3. I hope you know how to take the signs. In quadratic equation, you had studied this wavy curve method. Plus, minus, plus. Which sign do you want? Plus. So x belongs to, x can take any value from minus infinity to 2 union 3 to infinity. Any value if you will take, this will be defined. Hence the domain is minus infinity to 2 union 3 to infinity. Write down. One more problem. First finish this. One more problem. Find the domain of root over of find the domain of f of x equal to root over of 2x plus 1 by x cube minus 3x square plus 2x. Find the domain of 2x plus 1 by x cube minus 3x square plus 2x. So I want to say that this 2x plus 1 by x cube minus 3x square plus 2x should be greater than or equal to 0, and x cube minus 3x square plus 2x should not be equal to 0, isn't it? So if I will take x common, what will get? X square minus 3x plus 2, this should not be equal to 0, that is x into x minus 1 into x minus 2, this should not be equal to 0. So I want to say that 2x plus 1 by x into x minus 1 into x minus 2 should be greater than or equal to 0. Again I will apply the wavy curve. What are the roots? Upper root, numerator root is minus half, denominator roots are 0, 1 and 2. Now plot them in the number line, least root minus 1 by 2, then 0, then 1, then 2. As in wavy curve method, we will take extreme right as plus, then alternatively we will change the sign. So which sign do you want? Greater than or equal to 0 means positive sign. So x belongs to minus infinity to minus half. Minus half closed or open? I want to say that x can take minus half, because if x will take minus half, this will become 0. 0 by anything is 0 and root over of 0 is defined. So minus half will be closed. Union 0 to 1, and 0 and 1, both values it cannot take, because in both the values denominator is 0. Union 2 to infinity, again 2 it cannot take, because at 2 your denominator is 0. If x will take any value in this part, that function will be defined. So this is your domain. Understand? Next problem. Find the domain of f of x is equal to x square minus 2x plus 4 by x square plus 2x plus 4. So see that here there is no root over. So we should not bother about whether it is positive or negative. It can take anything, but the only thing we have to consider is denominator should not be equal to 0. Why? Because if denominator is 0, anything by 0 is not defined. So we should not worry at all about the numerator. Now check what is the denominator. Can I write denominator as x square plus 2x plus 1 plus 4 plus 3? See that 1 plus 3? 4. Can we write like this? That is, I want to say this is x square minus 2x plus 4 by x plus 1 whole square plus 3. Now see that denominator is perfect square plus something. Can perfect square be negative? Perfect square never be negative. It may be 0. When x is minus 1. When x is minus 1, this will become 0. But still 0 plus 3 can be 0? No. So denominator is always non-zero. If x is minus 1, then also it is 3. If x is not equal to minus 1, then it is always greater than 3. Means never be 0. If it is not 0, means this is always defined. Means if I will say what is the domain, you should simply say set of all real numbers. That is your domain. Now, classification of function or kinds of function. Classification of function. First one, 1-1 function. Classification of function. First one, 1-1 function. 1-1 function, or it is also called injective. 1-1 function or injective. A function f from a to b is called 1 1 is called 1 1 if different elements of A have different F images in B. Read it. A function f from A to B is said to be 1 1 if different elements of A have different F images in B. That is, if A comma B belongs to A such that A not equal to B, if two elements are different, then their images should also be different. If A not equal to B, then f of A not equal to f of B. Or this only, in other words, you can say, if two elements have same image, then those two elements should be equal. This is the process to check whether the two functions are, whether the given function is 1 1 or not. So what is the formula or definition? If two elements are different, then their F images should also be different. Or if the two elements F images are equal, then the two functions should be equal, that the two values should also be equal. Means, see that if I will say this is 1, 2, 3, this is A, B, C, a function I am defining from here to here such that f of 1 is B, f of 2 is C, f of 3 is B. So you see that 1 is not equal to 3. Or is 1 equal to 3? No. But what is f of 1? B. And what is f of 3? B. So f of 1 equal to f of 3. These two values are different, but their f images are same. So is it 1 1? No. Here we will say that this function is not 1 1. This function is not 1 1. But if I will give a example like this, suppose this is A 1 2 3 4 and B A B C D E. Here is the relation F such that 1 is taking D, 2 is taking A. I will give you a function F from A to B such that A is 1 2 3 4, B is A B C D E such that A is taking D, 2 is taking A, 3 taking C, 4 taking E. Then you see that if you will take any two different elements here, their images are also be different. So here we can say that this is 1 1 function. Did you understand 1 1 function? If the two elements are different, their images should also be different. Or if two images are same, the element should be same. This is the procedure to check whether the function is 1 1 or not. Graphically, next. See that, so if suppose a function given, this is one way to check. But if a graph is given and he will ask you that whether the graph is 1 1 or not, so write down graphically. Graphically, a function is 1 1 if no line parallel to x-axis cuts the graph at more than one point. You only see that suppose y equal to x square graph only if I will take. I will say it is not 1 1. Why? Because see that here is the element A, here is B, A element is this, B image is also this. These two are different, but their images are same. Suppose if I will say that f of x equal to x square, if I will ask what is f of minus 1? 1. F of 1. Minus 1 is not equal to 1, but f of minus 1 is equal to f of 1. So is it 1 1? No. So here if I will define f from R to R, but if I will say that f is defined from R plus to R plus, then it is 1 1. Why? Because now we should not take the whole graph. We should take only the graph in the positive side. This part we will not consider. Now if you will draw any line parallel to x-axis, it cuts the graph only at 1 point. Did you understand the thing? If a line parallel to x-axis cuts the graph at more than 1 point, then the given graph will not be the 1, 1 function parallel to x-axis. If it cut at more than 1 point, then the given function or given graph will not be 1, 1. Problem write down. Check whether his function is 1, 1 or not. Check whether his function is 1, 1 or not. Your function given is 1, 1 or not. Function is given as f of x is equal to 2x minus 3. F of x equal to 2x minus 3. So see that we have to check whether it is 1, 1 or not. So if I will say that f of a equal to, let f of a equal to f of b. If we can prove that a equal to b, we will say that it is 1, 1 according to the definition. But if a will not come equal to b, then we will say that it is not 1, 1. So let f of a equal to f of b. What does it mean? 2a minus 3 is equal to 2b minus 3. Minus 3 minus 3 cancel. So 2a equal to 2b. 2, 2 cancel. So a equal to b. We took f of a equal to f of b and we got a equal to b. So can we say that this is a 1, 1 function? Yes. So 2x minus 3 is a 1, 1 function. So checking 1, 1 function, so far how many methods we have? How many methods we have? First one, what? If a not equal to b, then f of a not equal to f of b. Or if f of a equal to b implies a equal to b. These are two methods. And third one, what I said, graphically. What? A given graph, if I will ask you, is it a 1, 1 function? You should say simply no, because a line parallel to x-axis cuts the graph at more than 1 point. But if I will say that, is it a 1, 1 function? You should say yes. Why? If you will draw any line parallel to x-axis, it cuts the graph only at 1 point. So this is 1, 1. But this is not 1, 1. Now, third way to check whether the function is 1, 1 or not is by using calculus. Using calculus. Using calculus, if f of x is strictly increasing means the graph will go like this or graph will go like this. If you see a graph which is strictly increasing, then you see that if you will draw any line parallel to x-axis, it will cut the graph only at 1 point. Here also, if you will draw any line parallel to x-axis, it will cut the graph only at 1 point. So graph is 1, 1. Or if f is strictly decreasing, means the graph is going like this or graph is going like this. See that again, any line parallel to x-axis cut the graph only at 1 point. So if you can see the graph which is strictly going up or strictly going down, you can simply say that graph will be 1, 1. But if a graph is increases, then decreases, then increases, then decreases, then you can say that the graph is not 1, 1, isn't it? A line parallel to x-axis cut the graph at more than 1 point. Have any confusion? So these are the methods to check whether the given graph is 1, 1 or not. Next, number of 1 1 functions, number of 1 1 functions. So first of all, see a small example I am giving. Suppose here the elements are a, b and c. What are the elements here? A, b and c. And here is the set which have only two elements, 1 and 2. What are the elements? 1 and 2. Now I want to ask that, can you give me a function? So you have to give some image of a. Suppose a took the image 1, then you have to take the image of b. You took, suppose b image as 2. Now you must take some image of c, na? Because suppose c have no image, then is it a function? No. So for it to be a function, c must have an image. So for c, what are the options left? C either it will take 1 or it will take 2. Suppose c took 1, is it a 1 1 function? No. Two different elements have same image. Suppose c took 2, is it a 1 1 function? No. Two different elements took same image, means in both the cases it is not 1 1. So can I say simply a small thing, that if number of elements in domain greater than number of elements in codomain, then number of 1 1 functions, number of 1 1 functions is 0. Agreed, there is no 1 1 function. But suppose here it is ABC and here it is 1 2 3. So give the image of A as 3, give the image of C as 1, give the image of B as 2. 1 1 function is existing or not? Means for getting a 1 1 function, minimum condition is number of elements in codomain should be equal to number of elements in domain. If number of elements in domain is greater than number of elements in codomain, then one thing surely we can say, that there will be no 1 1 function. Is it clear to you? Now suppose codomain have more number of elements. Suppose here it is ABC, here it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then see that this is A, this is 4, this is 3. See that 1 1 function exists. Isn't it? Another example, you can say that ABC 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, A to 5, B to 4, C to 3. 1 1 function. So if number of elements in codomain less than number of elements in codomain, then surely 1 1 function will exist. No? Number of 1 1 functions. Suppose this is a set A1, A2, A3 and so on, AM, and this is a set B1, B2, B3 and so on, BN. Here to here we will try to find how many number of 1 1 functions are there. So come on, tell me. A1 can take the image in how many ways? A1 image can be B1 or B2 or B3 or BN. So can take the image in how many ways? N ways. How many ways? N ways. Suppose A1 took some element BS, suppose. Then I am asking you that, can A2 take BS? No. Why? Because if A2 will also take BS, then two different elements have the same image. Is it possible? No. So if I will ask you, A2 can take the image in how many ways? Take out that element. How many ways? N minus 1 ways. A3 can take the image in how many ways? N minus 2 ways. No. In this way, AM can take the image in how many ways? Check it carefully. I want to say that N minus M plus M minus 1. Agreed? See that when it is 2, I will say 2 minus 1. When it is 3, I will say 3 minus 1. When it is 1, I will say 1 minus 1. Agreed? So A1 can take the image in N minus 1 minus 1. here 2 minus 1. Can I write this as 2 minus 1? Can I write this as 3 minus 1? So what will come here? N minus of m minus 1. Did you understand? So total number of ways. See that? A1 can take the image in n ways. This one will take in n minus 1 ways. This one will take is n minus 2 ways. And so on. This will take is n minus of m minus 1 ways. So total number of ways n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 and so on. N minus m plus 1. Agreed? If I will open the bracket. Now multiply and divide by n minus m factorial. Multiply and divide by n minus m factorial. So you will get numerator as n factorial, denominator as n minus m factorial, which is npm. npm. Did you understand? So see the final conclusion I am giving. Number of 1-1 functions. Number of 1-1 functions from a set containing m elements to another set containing n elements is equal to npm if n greater than or equal to m, 0 if n. This one already we had discussed, na? If number of elements in domain is greater than number of elements in codomain, number of 1-1 functions 0. But if n is greater than or equal to m, how much we got? npm. Again I am telling you it. The whole discussion which I gave is the concept of permutation and combination. If you know permutation and combination, I know that you will understand very easily all these things. But suppose you had not studied the permutation and combination, just my request is try to remember this formula. Final conclusion what I am giving, that if you remember, that is more than enough for the functions chapter. But if you had studied permutation and combination, I know that you will understand this one very easily. So this is about what is the function, what is its domain, what is its codomain, what is its range, and kinds of function in which so far you had studied 1-1 function. In next class we will study onto functions or bijections and inverse of a function. Onto function, surjection, bijection and inverse of a function, that and some various types of functions that we will study in the next class.